You're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper. Well, folks, tighten your seatbelts and get ready for a ride. Tonight's broadcast is going to be a little different, I think, than the normal fare here on WBCQ and the Hour of the Time. So, I've got to sort of set the stage here, and if you listen carefully, you might just get a little glimmer of what's going to come. Yeah, folks, love is on the air tonight. And I'm going to tell you all about it because, and don't go guessing because you're never going to guess what this is all about, believe me. I'm going to tell you about it. But first, I've got to tell you something else because my eyes are not getting better. And so I've got to be I guess a lot more unwilling to do a lot of work around here that I've been doing, which means I'm going to start farming some stuff out. And I've already got a couple of volunteers. Spencer has volunteered to help keep up the web pages. I'm sure that those of you with computers have noticed I haven't been keeping them up. I can't read. It's very difficult for me to do anything on the computer. It's difficult to do email. It's difficult to maintain the web pages. And my eyes got better to a point, and then they're not getting better now, which means I have to I just have to stop doing things that require that sort of a use of my eyes. So Spencer is going to be helping me with the web pages, and of course he's going to consult me, and there's going to be some other people helping, and we're going to get things done. We get right back up to speed. I was just very reluctant to admit that the problem was as bad as it is. So now that I've confronted it and have admitted it, maybe we can get on with what we've got to do. So thanks, Spencer, for volunteering, and the rest of you who have volunteered and are helping. Thank you, Linda, in Maryland, in D.C., for the help you've given me recently and the help that I know that you'll be giving us in the future. I don't know where to start with this, folks, because this is some pretty heavy stuff. You all heard the broadcast last night. It was a tape. Well, I got through the intro, you know, just to correct a couple of mistakes I made on the tape. That is the tape, by the way, that if you send a $25 donation, you can get that tape. You can also get it off the website in the Hot Shop. It's in the Hot Shop. So if you have a credit card and you want to go online, it's a secure transaction. You don't have to worry about anybody stealing your credit card number. It won't happen on any of our sites. I personally guarantee that. So if you want to go on the website, williamcooper.net, click on the Hot Shop, find the videotape section, and pick out the Lansing, Michigan talk. That's the one you heard last night. It's a very good one. I'm pretty proud of that. And order that. You can show it in your local cable access television station. You can show it to your neighbors. You know, make sure that people get to see it, because it's a good tape. It's a real good tape. But the reason I did it, I hadn't planned to do that, folks. But about 2 hours before broadcast time, in fact, exactly 2 hours before broadcast time, I went to my email, and I found an email there that literally has changed my whole life. Rocked me back on my heels. Felt like somebody fired a cannonball right through my chest. Powerful email. Scary. Scared the living hell out of me. I'm going to read it to you right now. And I think as I read this to you, you're going to understand why. It says, "Hi. I'm not sure what to say or how to start this. I guess just, I am your daughter. I've been looking for you for so many years, I'd almost given up. I got this website name from Aunt Connie. Grandpa told me she contacted you on it when Grandma had her stroke. My name is Jessica Dovey Cooper, and I feel it's time for me to meet the man whose last name has followed my first for the past 20 years. I feel as if there is one thing I should make clear to you from the start. I have no ill will towards you. I don't hate or resent you. And I'm not looking for some perfect father figure to enter my life as if he was always there. I don't even want money. I just want you. I look in the mirror and see a stranger's face. A bit of my mother, of course. But then there are those characteristics that are just sort of there. I want to see the face of my father in my own, but I can't. I've never seen the face of my father at all. I have some old black and white photos of you that Grandma sent me, but they are small and from a long time ago. I met my brother, your son Anthony, and my sister Jennifer as well a few years back. I am slightly calmed as I write to you by the fact that you were so receptive and nice to Tony when he contacted you for the first time. Jenny said you were nice as well. I can only dream that you will show the same receptive attitude and loving kindness to me. Please email me as soon as you can. respectively, Jessica D. Cooper. Well, last night I could never have done this. Last night was a very emotional time for me. And when I first read this, I couldn't believe it. I thought somebody was messing around with my head. And so I read it again. And then again. And then I started getting hung up in certain places and trying to figure out, what does this mean, you know? And then I became very emotional. And I read it again and again. I must have read it 40 or 50 times before I picked up the phone and called Doyle. And I told Doyle, I said, Doyle, you got to get up here. I need a little bit of help. I'm sort of bewildered and a little scared. And of course, he didn't know what I was talking about. So he zipped up here real quick and I set him down at the computer and I said, here, read this. I said, I've read it about 40 or 50 times. And I don't know if it's real or somebody's trying to screw around with me or what. I said, I hope it's real. Sure brought up a lot of emotion and memories and a lot of repressed feelings and a lot of love. And quite a few tears, I might add. So I couldn't have done last night's show if I wanted to in a million years. Not live, anyway. So I chose to do it the way that I did it. Doyle read it, and he said he couldn't tell. But he had this strange feeling that it wasn't really her. He didn't know why. And I was scared. First time in many years I've been scared. Scared me. And at the same time, I had this incredible hope. And all this love for a little girl that I'd left when she was about 4 years old. And by the way, folks, I didn't leave her. She was taken away from me. I tried everything that I could do to hold that family together. But her mother somehow met another man and fell in love with him. And I'm not faulting her, and I'm not trying to degrade her or make her feel bad or look bad or anything. It's something that happened. And no matter how hard I tried, it just wasn't going to work. And so, there were two choices. Results of violence and snatcher, or just move on. And I just moved on. I couldn't hurt people that I loved anyway. And I'm going to say something right now that many of you will never understand. Some of you might. I hope that some of you will. I've loved a lot of people in my life, men and women. I love Doyle. He's my brother. I know a lot of men who could never say that about another man in a million years, but I can. It has nothing to do with homosexuality. It's reality. But I've been very lucky in my life. I have been lucky enough to have been loved and been able to love in return some of the most wonderful, most beautiful, intelligent women that you could possibly imagine. And Jessica's mother was one of those women. In fact, Sally was the most beautiful woman that I have ever met in my entire life. She was brilliantly intelligent, witty and sharp and fun. And when she walked into a room, every eye looked at her. I was proud just to be with her. While we loved each other, it was probably one of the greatest loves that's ever existed in the history of the earth. And when we were angry and fought, we fought tooth and nail. We were both very passionate people. I still am a very passionate man. She really was born into a family of two people who really loved each other. Sally was always kind of a gypsy. Eventually, she just had to move on. I still, today, love everybody that I've ever loved in my entire life just as much now as I did then. And I don't care who it is. My brother, my sister, the first girl that I ever kissed, my first big love, everybody. Bob Swan has been my best friend all my life. I love Bob. I love Doyle. I love Sally. I love Linda. I love Annie. I love these people. I love Jessica. I love Jennifer. I love Tony. I love Pooh and Allison. And I love them just as much today as I ever loved them in my life, all of them. And I know some people can't understand that. A lot of people think that when you break up a relationship that you have to stop loving each other. I've never felt that way in my life. I don't believe it, you see. And I could no more stop loving somebody that I loved yesterday, today, than I could successfully chop off my right arm without even grimacing. I couldn't do it. So, there you are. So this brought up all of that feeling. And Jessica, when she was born, was a beautiful little girl, and I loved her very much. I had just completed a degree in photography, and by the way, she was born April the 2nd, 1980. I've never forgotten the birthdays of any of my children. And so she's 20 years old this year. I haven't seen her since she was about 4 years old. But during those 4 years old, I loved her. So when she says on here, I've never seen the face of my father at all, it's because she doesn't remember. Because I loved her dearly. I rocked her, I sang to her, I changed her little poopy diapers and gave her baths and pushed her in her stroller and tickled her, and she'd squeal and laugh and crawl, and I'd tickle her again and hold her and love her. Happy. She was very happy little, just like Pooh. Pooh and Jessica were very alike when they were little. Loved people, loved strangers, laughed and talked to anybody and was happy and just took in the world. And so, you can imagine what this did to me. I emailed this message to Linda back in Maryland, and because she's a dear friend, and asked her to sort of read it and feel it out, and if she felt it necessary to email the person, because this was from somebody else. It was from somebody named John Applegarth. It wasn't from Jessica in the email message. It was from somebody named John Applegarth at AOL.com. And don't bother emailing that, because the last part is not real. First part is. Last part's not. And so I wasn't sure what was really going on here. Linda read it a couple of times, I guess, and emailed me back. And she said, I really feel that this is real, Bill, and you better write to her right away. And so I did. I sat down and I composed a message and sent it off to her. And basically what I said was, please be my little Jessica. You're wrong when you say you have never seen the face of your father. I loved you so much. I changed your little diapers, sang to you, rocked you, bathed you, read to you, photographed you endlessly. Your mother kept the photos, many of which were very good, and took you wherever I went. You were such a happy and intelligent little girl, and I loved you. And sat there. Doyle, in the meantime, went down to Safeway and got a bottle of scotch. And came back up and poured us both a stiff drink of scotch. And I got to tell you right now, I needed it. About an hour later, I got another email back from Jessica. And here's what it said. Daddy! ! Well, that stopped me right in my tracks, and I couldn't get past that point. I literally couldn't get past. I kept reading that over and over again. Daddy! ! And I knew that I had struck gold. kind of gold that pretty hard to come by. Daddy! Exclamation point. And as hard as I could to read, try to read the next sentence, I couldn't get past Daddy! Exclamation point. I just kept looking at that, reading it again. And then finally, I was able to go on. And the next sentence said, "You are nice to me!" Exclamation point. Parentheses, W-H-E-W, close parentheses. And that hung me up for a little while. All of a sudden, I realized the apprehension that this little girl was feeling, just like I was feeling. Then I felt very close to her. "I have no idea what to say to you. I am so overwhelmed and full of wonderful yet confusing emotions which are swirling furiously through my brain." Exactly as I felt. "I guess I never really dreamed that I would find you. And when I did, part of me just didn't believe it was you." Can you imagine this? Well, she was thinking the exact same thoughts that were racing through my mind. Scared, both of us. Scared. Then I began to get my hopes up. "But I didn't think you would email me back. When I got home and I saw the message you sent me, I almost died from shock and excitement. I miss you. I don't know you, but I miss you. And I could never have dreamed that..." "I could never have dreamed that you missed me too. I want to hug you and hold you and kiss you and never let go." And right about then, the tears just started to flow. And there was this big baby sitting in front of the computer, just eyes so full of tears I couldn't read anything anymore. It's pretty hard for me to hold it back right now. Pretty difficult, I can assure you. But I'm going to endeavor to do that, because I don't want this to turn into some mushy thing here. It's much, much more beautiful than that, I think. I hope you get this email when I send it, not later. It is late here, and I have to sleep, but I have to wait at least a little while to see if you mail me back tonight. I heard from Tony that you had written a book and always wanted a copy, but I didn't know the name of it. I have looked for you for so long, almost 5 years now, searching on my own. I went to lengths you would never believe, and all the while, here you are right before my eyes. You are on the net, in print, and on the air, but I couldn't find you. I couldn't find you. I never had the money for an investigation. I want to know everything about you, and selfishly, especially the part of you when there was me. Father's Day is coming up soon. Father's Day Father's Day is coming up soon, a day which is always sad and very hard for me. Well, folks, it's always been very hard for me, too. You've heard me talk about the loss of my children. For over the past year, after having sent Annie and Pooh and Allison away out of the country, I've literally been in mourning. I've grieved. as if they'd all died. And so I know what she's talking about when she says Father's Day is hard for her. Very hard for me, too. It's hard for every child who lost their father and every father who lost their children. And Mother's Day is the same way for mothers. Father's Day is coming up soon, a day which is always sad and very hard for me. I'm exhilarated to know that this year I really have a father for the day. What perfect timing, eh? By the way, I hear you. I have so much to say, but I will wait to see how you respond to this much first. This is really the most important day of my 20 little years so far. Thank you, your old daughter, Jessica. Now, I got to tell you, folks, that just touched me more than I've ever been touched in my whole life by just about anything. And just sent me reeling for the whole night long. I fell asleep at the computer, woke up there this morning with key prints all over my face. Key prints all over my face, waiting for email. And we have exchanged quite a few emails. She called this afternoon about 3:30. And we talked for a long, long time. For some reason, I guess God decided to bless the both of us. And I am so thankful to Jessica and to my God for allowing that to happen. And now she wants to come and see me. Boy, won't that be something? Might cause a flood here in Eager, gotta tell you. So you better start building your dikes right now. But we need the water really bad. So I don't think anybody will complain. So, Jessica, this is for you. Thank you.
be true. Oh, honey, don't you know? Most of all, I miss you more than you know.
Well, Jessica's not listening. She doesn't have a shortwave radio, and I don't think she has the capacity with her computer to listen to the broadcast on the internet, although I think she's frantically running around trying to figure out how to do one or the other. Tonight she will be in the chat room with me, if you'd all like to join us there, at williamcooper.net. Go down to the chat room at about 8:15. I'll be there. And Jessica is going to be there also. And I thought that it might be a good idea, and I asked her if she wanted to sort of get to know what all of us are all about. And so that's a good way to do it, because you know me probably more than anybody. But the phones are open if you'd like to call. We'll be in the chat room at about 8:15. And the reason for that is she wanted to meet me in the chat room, and I asked her if it was okay if I invited the listening audience, since you all know me so much. I imagine that she has about 5 million questions to ask everybody. So it might be an experience. You may not want to come. I don't know. Good evening. You're on the air.
Mr. Cooper.
Yes.
Captain Audio.
Hello, Captain Audio.
I am very touched by your story.
Uh-huh.
I never met my mom till I was 32 years old.
Wow.
And finally I did. And she had 4 sons. I was one, the second. All 3 are gone now. I was the only son to give her grandchildren. We maintain a relationship to this very day.
Well, I think that's wonderful.
I think your story is wonderful also.
Well, thank you.
Yes, sir.
It certainly has, like I said at the beginning, it's changed my whole life. I mean, it really has.
I'm sure.
I may even learn how to be a kinder, more gentler man now.
Oh, my gosh. Don't go out of control now, but...
Well, I can already feel that this experience has taken a little bit of the anger out of my soul.
Is that so?
I can already feel that. It's really happened. I've always blamed this new world order, this social engineering crap, for a lot of stuff that's happened to a lot of us. There was a period of time when men and women didn't even know how to act toward each other anymore.
I agree.
And what you had been taught turned out that's not what you were supposed to be doing. I remember getting cussed out by a woman one time just for opening the door for her. Something that I'd been taught by my mother was basic manners that a man was obligated to do for a woman.
Being a southern gentleman myself, I fully understand manners. And I think Gloria Steinem was the absolute antithesis of the nuclear family. Myself.
Yeah.
I think she has confused many young ladies to this very day.
I think so, too. I've always, you know, Gloria Steinem has always been a little target of mine.
I just do wish to congratulate you for being reunited with a progeny. And I think that if my experience proves to be true, which it has so far for me, that you should pursue that and you should go with it in every way, shape, and form. And you might actually find on this planet a love you never knew existed.
Well, thank you very much for those comments.
Yes, sir.
I appreciate it.
My blessings and my pleasure.
Thank you for calling.
Yes, sir.
Wild horses couldn't stop me from pursuing this, folks. It would be impossible. 520-333-4578 is the number. Once again, I want to invite the listening audience, if you'd like to come to the chat room go to williamcooper.net and go down to the chat room and sign in, and I'll be there at about 8:15, and Jessica's going to come in there about that time or maybe a little later. Good evening, you're on the air.
Good evening, Bill. This is David, and I'm calling from Rhode Island.
Hi, David.
And I listen on WBCQ out of Monticello, Maine.
Uh-huh.
And I always really touching story.
Thank you.
And I greatly appreciate, although I'm a new listener, I greatly appreciate the effort which you give in making people research and check things for themselves and not listen to anybody until they know the fact is on paper and it's documentable, and then passing the word.
Yeah, I want them to listen to everybody, but not believe. That's the key thing. Don't believe it unless you can prove it.
And I've been very impressed with the way you handle the callers, because sometimes we all get emotional over issues, and without some pullback to reality, people will go off on tangents.
Oh, yeah.
I want to call and say thank you, appreciate the program, and good luck on your new future.
Thank you very much.
Have a good night, Bill.
Thank you for calling. Good evening, you're on here.
Yes, Mr. Cooper.
Yes, sir.
I have listened to you since, March of 93. I've never called about various political things, which I could have. But you said something tonight that really struck my heart. My daughters are now 21 and 23. I divorced their mom in 84. They call me daddy to this day. There is no greater honor than for a child to call their father daddy. You have done good with those children.
Well, thank you.
And just keep it up with those kids. Be there for them.
I'm going to try. Isn't it amazing, though, that as public as I have always been, with the number one best-selling underground book that's ever been published in the history of publishing, not just the United States, but the history of publishing, on radio, I've been the guest on many other radio shows across the country over the years, on television, I've been discussed by Ted Koppel on Nightline, on the Rush Limbaugh broadcast. The president called me the most dangerous radio host in America, and she never could find me.
Well,
isn't that absolutely an amazing thing?
Well, you did good, and as long as you can succeed as a father, nobody can tear you down for anything else, because you have accomplished a major accomplishment. So God bless.
Thank you.
And just keep me in a dance.
Okay. Thanks for calling.
Bye-bye.
520-333-4578 is the number. And I'm going to take your calls for the rest of the hour. And if you'd like to join Jessica and I in the chat room, we'll be there at about 8:15. WilliamCooper.net. Go down the page till you find the chat room. Click on it. And the chat page comes up. Sign in, and we'll meet you there. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, Bill. It's Cal here from Michigan.
Hi, Cal. How are you? How's Denise?
She's doing great.
How's the baby?
Funky and just full of love.
Now, don't do what I did and let that baby go.
No way.
Okay.
Bill, God is good.
Yes. Yes.
I'd like to congratulate Jessica for taking that leap of faith and reaching out.
Well, she sure did, didn't she? And I know that she was terrified because I was terrified.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm sitting here where we're listening, and I'm telling you, my heart almost burst.
Well, thanks, Cal. You know, I didn't think anything else could ever scare me ever again. I was terrified when I read that email. I mean, just literally scared to death.
I can only imagine. I can only imagine. But I tell you what, listening to your voice, it sounds like your cup runneth over.
Oh, well, right now, that's what I'm feeling.
Well, I tell you what.
And a byproduct is I wasn't joking a while ago. I really feel some of the anger that's been in my heart for a lot of years is gone now. It's just gone.
That is nothing but wonderful. I mean, boy, I tell you, I got a grin on my face so big I'm afraid.
Well, watch out now. A little critter might jump in there. How's the critter?
She's doing pretty good. They're spicy.
Yeah, I bet. How's the baby and the critter get along?
Oh, wonderful. You wouldn't believe it. Oh, she gets so excited. You'd have to see it. Yeah? And full of love. Oh, boy. I'm telling you.
Well, that's great.
Yeah. I'm just so excited about this broadcast, I don't know what to do.
Well, thanks, Cal.
I'm sitting here with a good grin on my face, and the only thing I kept saying is, God is good.
Yes.
Most definitely.
Well, thank you.
Well, Bill, we love you.
Give everybody a hug for me, will you?
Most absolutely. And Jessica, we love you, and welcome.
Thank you.
So take care there, Bill.
Okay. Thanks for calling. Yeah, she's not listening tonight, but I am going to send her a copy of this tape. I couldn't not do this show. I had to do this show. If not tonight, it would have been tomorrow night or next. I had to do it. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hello, Bill. This is Tim.
Hi, Tim.
Sound like you're having a fantastic evening.
Oh, yes.
I know exactly the feeling. I had a daughter that was separated from me before she was born. And one day, 5 years ago, I got a phone call. And she was 25 years old.
Isn't that amazing? You know, when I read Jessica's email and realized she was 20, it was hard for me to grasp that because the last time I saw her, she was just a little tiny 4-year-old girl.
Wow. Yeah, it's really amazing. Time seems to slip away.
Yeah.
But it turned out really good for us. I hope it turns out as good for you. My daughter and I, we now share 20 acres in South Central Texas. It's nothing spectacular, but it's all we could afford. And we got a horse and a bunch of dogs and geese and chickens, and I've got a brand new grandbaby, and I'm just tickled doo-doo, so to speak.
Well, that's about the way I feel. Thank you.
Okay, God bless, and thank you for your service, Bill.
Thank you for calling.
Bye-bye.
520-333-4578 is the number. Jessica and I will be in the chat room at about 8:15 or somewhere around there. She may come in a little late. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. This is Jean.
Hi, Mom.
I just wanted to tell you I'm sitting here and I have been crying and just rejoicing with you.
Well, thank you. I think probably a lot of your prayers probably made it happen. I don't know. You pray more for me than anybody has ever prayed for me in my whole life.
I really do. And what I wanted to share with you is, you know, I've shared with, or Annie has told me over the years about, you know, the loss of your children and how much it meant to you. And about over a month ago, we were at church on a prayer night, and a message came from our pastor that there was just going to be a restoration. And, of course, I put in for you and Annie and the girls. You know, but, you know, God had other plans. But I just wanted to know, I am so delighted. Oh, and I'm so happy for her.
Well, thank you, Jean.
Well,
and I want to thank you for all the stuff you've been sending me. But I got to tell you, that energies you sent me?
Uh-huh.
I took one of those, and I can't handle that. That wired me. The other stuff, the laser mind, I like that. That sort of sharpens up my mental ability without making me feel like I'd taken some kind of dope or something. It's all herbal stuff, folks.
Yeah. Listen, we got our little dog, so I feel, you know, we thought we were going to lose him, but now I just have to realize we've got to get your eyes better, so that's next on the list.
Oh, well, thank you, Jean.
Okay. Listen, my best to you.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Bye-bye. And I love you too, Jean.
Boy, I love you so much, you'll never know.
I hope you know that.
I know.
Thank you.
Good night.
Bye-bye. Yeah, that's Jean's like a mother to me. I mean, she takes care of me. She prays for me and sends me videotapes and little herbal preparations for my health. And there are several people who do that, but Jean is... I love Jean. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yeah, hi, Mr. Cooper. This is Virginia.
Hi, Virginia. How are you?
I'm fine. And I tell you what, this could not happen to a better man.
Well, thank you so much.
He is absolutely enriched by your... being her father, and I must tell you that not everyone has a father that will fight for his country at great loss to himself, and that is what you are, sir.
Well, thank you, Virginia.
I get emotional myself.
Well, and this, that's okay, because, this is a pretty emotional subject. I None of you would have recognized me yesterday.
Well, whenever you put a rerun on, I think there's something going on, so, yeah. You know, we understand.
Well, I'm not as tough as you all think I am, really.
Well, we don't really. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I was just laughing.
Well, I am really happy for you, and it could not come at a better time.
Well, thank you.
Yeah,
you're right about that. Yeah.
We're your radio family out here, and we just love to hear when things happen to you that are really good.
Well, it's about time something good happened, huh?
Well, I think so.
I was beginning to wonder if anything good was ever going to happen to me again.
Well, you know something? I had a thought the night you were talking about Sugar Bear and the chickens.
Uh-huh.
I was thinking, why don't you get him his own chicken?
Well, you know, that's not a bad idea. And if I could train the chicken to live in the doghouse, and Sugar Bear would adopt the chicken as his own, he would guard the chicken, so
what
nobody.
What about when you got it if it was a young chick?
Well, that might. You know, I had a dog that had puppies one time,
mm-hmm.
And I found this little Siamese cat whose mother had died, and it was just a little tiny thing. I put it in with the puppies, and it nursed off the dog and was raised by the dog, and that cat thought it was a dog its whole life. Yeah, true. It happened in Hawaii.
Oh, golly. Well, I just wanted to say thank you for you, Mr. Cooper, and I tell you, your daughter could not have a better father.
Well, thank you so much.
Okay, good night.
I'm sure she'll be glad to know that.
Oh, well, there's no doubt about it. She has a really good father, wonderful father.
Well, thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Yeah, I imagine she's worried about that. Even with all the exchange of email and talking on the phone, I imagine she's still a little scared, you know. I think she's probably nervous. She wants to come and see me. I want her to come so much, and somehow we'll arrange for that to happen. 520-333-4578 is the number. Once again, we'll be in the chat room about 8:15, somewhere around there. Just go to williamcooper.net, go down to the chat room, click on that link, and when the chat page comes up, sign in, and there you'll be. And she may not come on at all. You know, she wanted to meet me in the chat room. I told her there may be some other people there from the listening audience, and she wanted to meet them, but, you know, she might get cold feet and back out. I don't know, but I'll be there. Okay, and I hope she shows up, and if she does, and you're all there, then we'll just make a wonderful evening out of it, and you'll get to meet my daughter. Won't that be something? 520-333-4578 is the number. Good evening, you're on the air.
Oh, Bill Cooper.
Yes, sir.
Daughter.
Thank you. She found me, actually. But
well,
but thank you. Go ahead.
I have a similar type situation, only I don't know how to go about locating mine.
Well, maybe we'll do a broadcast one night about how to go about that, because it's really very easy. It's easy to find people today like never before. You can find them really, really easy if you just know how to go about it. She didn't know how to go about it, or she would have found me in 5 minutes. All you got to do is do an internet search of my name, and you'll come up with about 500 things to explore.
I was concerned mostly, though, about your vision problem.
Yeah.
Have you had a diagnosis?
Yeah, but I'm a little hesitant to say what it is over the air. Just suffice it to say it's a little more serious than what I thought it was. It has nothing to do with the computer.
Oh, nothing to do with the computer?
No.
Okay, that's what was on my mind.
Nope, it has nothing to do with the computer.
A friend of mine has gone through this, and this is about the third time he's had I can't remember the phrase now, the proper title. Anyway, he's having to give up his job because he cannot spend much time looking at a computer screen.
Yeah, I can't even read a book anymore, and that's terrible to me because I love books. I devour books like some people eat popcorn, and now I can't even read a page. Well, great. What do you think of it?
I've bought it three times over the last several years. Yeah. And the reason is because each time I bought that book, it has disappeared.
Yeah, it has a tendency to do that. Barnes & Noble says it's the most stolen book that they've ever had in their inventory.
I believe that. But I have bought the book three times, and I have successfully completed reading the book, but for some reason or another, it disappears.
Yeah.
And I don't understand why.
Well, I don't either, but I've been hearing this for years. And one of the things you don't want to do with my book, unless you have another copy, is loan it to somebody. They never give it back. They won't give it back if you threaten them.
never loaned it to anybody that I can remember except possibly my brother. And he would give it back if he'd taken it.
Well, you're lucky, because most people never have that experience. Once they loan it, it never comes back.
Well, I think maybe... I remember I took one of the copies to work once, and that may well be where it disappeared. But the other two, I don't have a clue. It's just like they just weren't there.
Yeah. Well, I understand. I've been hearing this for years from everybody, and it's still the largest, it's still the number one best-selling underground book of all time. Did you know that people of all ethnic origins used to sell my book on the street corners in New York City and Chicago?
I was told that by somebody I met in Fort Wayne a few years ago, and I don't remember the conversation, but he remembered having seen the book. It was in Chicago, and I think he said it's somewhere on State Street.
Yeah, it's
an outdoor vendor, he said.
It's amazing. It's amazing. Okay, thanks for calling.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. 520-333-4578 is the number. Yeah, I feel so lucky tonight. I feel so blessed. I'm so happy and tremendously relieved. Good evening. You're on the air. Thank you. Could you talk a lot louder, please? I can barely hear you.
God bless Mr. Cooper.
Well, thank you.
A lot of people are praying, and I hope, and God will open up, as your heart opens up, God will give you blessings. Unbelievable. God bless you.
Thank you very much. 520-333-4578. Thank you for calling. And thank you for those very kind words. I really appreciate that. 520-333-4578 is the number. And we've got time for maybe two more callers. Before, we have to hang it up. And like I said before, if you'd like to go to williamcooper.net, go down the page to the chat room. We'll meet you in the chat room at about 8:15. And so that should be interesting, I think. For those of you who have computers and want to try that out, we haven't done that in a long time. We've done it before in the past. Haven't done it in a while. 520-333-4578. Is the number. For those of you living in the Round Valley, immediately following the hour of the time, there will be a special presentation of Project Red Light 2, which is the sequel to Project Red Light, which was the very first video or film ever made by anybody about Area 51, and I produced and filmed and directed and edited both of those. And they're really my first attempts at filmmaking, so a little amateurish, but loaded with information that you cannot and will not ever see anywhere else. So if you're in the Round Valley, tune in to Round Valley Television Channel 15 immediately following the hour of the time for Project Red Light 2, Channel 15, Round Valley Television, immediately following the hour of the time. Well, that's about it, folks. We got to wrap it up because we're out of time. So God bless each and every single one of you. Thank you, God, for blessing me and returning my daughter to me. Thank you, Jessica, for having the courage to search me out and find me and have the courage to send that email. I love you very much, and I've missed you for many, many years. And I think this is the beginning of a wonderful relationship that's going to last for the rest of our lives. I love you. Good night, Andy Poo and Allison. I love you. You're always in my thoughts, in my dreams, and always with me in my heart. Why I wonder, there
to leave.